First up in the final group, second after the short program, Miki Ando of Japan.
And everyone's focused on Yuna, but you cannot count Miki out. And as you said before, they're virtually tied. She's known for her technical ability, but somehow in this last half of the season, it seems even that much more improved. She opens with a triple Lutz, double loop. Nails it. I don't understand at this event is why she hasn't added the triple-triple, especially knowing Yuna is going to be at Worlds. During my career, I skated against Michelle. I knew how good she was. I knew I had to do something that no one else was doing and risk it. It's not the best feeling, but sometimes that has to be your strategy. Slight mistake there, a turnout on a double toe, which should have been a triple toe. Good. That's one thing the other competitors should take note from, is how focused Miki can stay in her outlook toward competing. It's not about technique, it's not about the other competitors, it's about pacing and not thinking, and she does that well.
Well, she's learned that throughout her career. I mean, I remember in 2006 when she showed up in Torino, caved under the pressure from the Japanese media, finished 15th, stuck around, fought her way back, 5th in Vancouver. But this is a skater you can never count out.
Never. She's way too consistent. Well, that was good.
Looks like a little bit of relief there. Her coach,
she Nikolai
Morozov.
Title.
Hard to tell if that will be good enough for a second world title for Miki Ando.
Still have Yuna.
130.21, the free skate score. That is a borderline great phenomenal score in terms of our system that we have, anything over 130 is considered phenomenal.
It's a good score.
Yep.
She got the job done.
Puts her in first place, not her best of this season.
You pulled in.
And the Lady World Fever champion for 2011, Miki Ando, Japan.